Hello dear learners, today we are going to talk about the cholinergic neurotransmitter, that is acetylcholine, with respect to pharmaceutical chemistry too. Now as you all know, acetylcholine is the neurotransmitter wherein it involves parasympathetic system. As you all know, autonomic nervous system is subdivided into two. First is parasympathetic system and another one is sympathetic system. So with respect to parasympathetic system, the neurotransmitter involved in case of parasympathetic system is acetylcholine. So we are going to talk about the properties, uses. As you can see here, the topics which we are going to discuss are its structure. We are going to talk about the IUPAC, then properties, uses, its official preparations and brand names. So the next slide is acetylcholine. As you can see here in the properties of acetylcholine, the physical state is crystalline. It is white crystalline powder, as you can see here in the image, which is white crystalline powder. It is having an ammonium odor and its taste is saline. The nature is hygroscopic. So hygroscopic is nothing but it absorbs moisture in presence of air. And the solubility is, it is very soluble in water as well as organic solvent, that is alcohol. And the aqueous solutions made out of the acetylcholine's white crystalline powder are generally unstable. Incompatibilities, it is incompatible with the acids and alkalis. Its storage, as we have seen that it is hygroscopic in nature, so it should be stored in airtight container as well as it is to be protected from the light. Next, to talk about the structure, is like the IUPAC and structure. As you can see here in the image, I have highlighted the acetylcholine structure into three parts. The first part, very first part on the screen, which you can see is this part, which is a quaternary ammonium. Okay, so that N is having the substitution 3 methyl groups. So it is what? It is trimethyl. And since, as you can see here, it is chloride salt, it is trimethyl ammonium, this N, and this is chloride. So at the end, you can see here, it is trimethyl ammonium chloride. And if you will go ahead, these are two carbon chain. So these are two carbons and it is a chain. So it is nothing but ethyl. So CH2CH2. So if you look into the numbering, this is first carbon and this is second carbon. So on second carbon, what is present? So as you can see here, the third highlighted portion, which is nothing but, as you all know, this is acetyl group. And since one oxy is attached to it, it is called as acetoxy. So this complete is acetoxy. This is ethyl chain, wherein on first carbon, it is trimethyl ammonium, and second carbon, it is acetoxy. So the chain is ethyl. So here, if you will talk about from this end, this is trimethyl ammonium chloride, ethyl and acetoxy, which is on second carbon. So the name is 2-acetoxy ethyl trimethyl ammonium chloride. So this was with respect to structure and IUPAC. As you can see here in the image, it's a nerve fiber. Okay, so we all know that presynaptic and postsynaptic concept is there. Presynaptic is before synapse, and postsynaptic, so preganglionic and postganglionic is there. Okay, so preganglionic is what? It is pre means before, so it is, this is the ganglia. So this is before ganglia, that's why it is called as preganglionic, and this is after ganglia, so it is called as postganglionic. Means this is the ganglia, previous to this is preganglionic, and after to this is postganglionic nerve fiber. And postganglionic nerve fiber, at the end you can find here it is effector organ. So whatever the neurotransmitter is released from the postganglionic nerve fiber, this will be received by the receptors which are present on the effector organ. So here if you will see, according to the receptor ka presence on the ganglia, nicotinic receptors are present. Like this nerve fiber will release acetylcholine. Here nicotinic receptors are present on the postsynaptic nerve fiber. And here when acetylcholine is released from the axon ka terminals, the effector organ is having the receptors which are present on the surface are muscarinic receptors. So we will see this with the help of one image. The receptors, as you can see, the receptors present are two cholinergic receptors are there. Okay, the parasympathetic system ka receptors are muscarinic receptors and nicotinic receptors. So muscarinic receptors are further subdivided into M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M1 to M5. And nicotinic receptors are further subdivided into NM and NN. So for this receptors, you are supposed to go through the previous video first, that is parasympathetic receptors or cholinergic system receptors, okay, and their nature. So this muscarinic receptors M1, M2, M3, M4, as we have discussed in our earlier video, how you are supposed to remember the nature of these receptors and location. So please just go through that video, and I would like to explain in short that how we are supposed to remember the nature, that E1 are inhibitory in nature and odd are stimulatory in nature. So here E is there and I is there. E1 inhibitory, matlab M3, M5, M1 जो है वो इनहिबिटरी है, सॉरी दिस M2, M4, E1 नंबर कौन सा है, इट इज 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 में 1, 3 and 5 इज ऑड एंड 2 and 4 इज E1. ओके, सो E1 जो है, M2 एंड M4 आर इनहिबिटरी इन नेचर, एंड M1, M3, M5 सिंस दिस आर ऑड नंबर्स सो दे आर स्टिमुलेटरी इन नेचर. दैट मीन्स wherever M1, M3, M5 will be present, it will produce stimulation since the nature is stimulatory, and wherever M2, M4 are present, it will produce the inhibitory action. So nicotinic receptors in motinikita and natinikita hai. So this NM stands for neuromuscular junction and this is for autonomic ganglia. The next is, as you can see here in the image, see preganglionic neuron ka ye hai this neuron. Okay, these are the axon terminals. Okay, so ye yahan pe acetylcholine release ho raha hai, fir ye ganglia pe we have seen that nicotinic receptors are present, so these are nicotinic receptors which are receiving the acetylcholine, okay, of this postganglionic neuron. If you go for axon terminal, here they are releasing norepinephrine since the system is sympathetic system. And in case of parasympathetic system, which is of the system of interest right now, here if you will see, the preganglionic neuron is releasing the acetylcholine at the axon terminals, and this postganglionic neuron is receiving the acetylcholine with the help of the nicotinic receptors which are present on the surface of the postganglionic neuron. And this acetylcholine again is further released and it is affecting the target cell based on the receptor present. Matlab kya? Yaha pe muscarinic receptors present hai. See, as you can see here, muscarinic receptors. So if it is M1, it will produce what? Since it is odd number, it will produce the stimulation. If it is M2, since it is even number, it will produce the inhibitory effect. So like that. So this pictorial representation was for you people to understand. So next we will see here. This will come later. Next is, as you can see here, again this is preganglionic neuron, postganglionic neuron. Here is the effector. So now we will see the effects produced by this parasympathetic system and acetylcholine, which is the main neurotransmitter. That means whatever the acetylcholine's effect are produced, that are mimicking the parasympathetic system. That means parasympathetic system, basically if you will see this ANS, sympathetic and parasympathetic system, is innervating basically the muscles, okay, skeletal muscles and all, and it is innervating to the secretory glands also. So it is basically involved, the functions are involved with respect to secretory glands and the muscles. So as we start here, like this is the ganglion, okay, and one thing which you are supposed to notice is here, it is in case of parasympathetic system, this preganglionic neuron is long whereas post is short, and in case of sympathetic, the preganglionic is short and post is long. So para ka pre is long, para pre is long, okay. Now here, as you can see from the ganglion, okay, it is innervating various effector organs. So here first, if we start with the eyes, okay, so eyes may, since the M3 receptors are present. Now ye kaise hai eyes pe, ab iske locations bhi previous video mein we have covered, okay, what are the locations and what are the receptors and how you are supposed to remember it, okay. So on eyes, M3 receptors are present. It is odd in number, so it is stimulatory, so it will produce the muscle ka contraction. So it will contract the pupils and it will produce meiotic effect, as you can see here in the image. It is a short acting meiotic in eyes during cataract surgery. Matlab ye pupil ka contraction karta hai. So how? See, these are the normal pupils, these are constricted pupils and these are dilated pupil. So this will produce the pupil ka contraction and M3 receptors are present. Then next, if you will see lungs, here M3 receptors again. So M3, since it is odd number, it is stimulatory in nature. So it is going to constrict the bronchioles. So it is having a bronchoconstrictory effect. And since the bronchioles are constricted, it will increase the secretions. Okay. The secretions will be secreted out. Then next is heart. So on heart, since the receptors located are M2 receptor, now M2, since it is a even number, it will produce the inhibitory effect on the heart as well as blood vessels, since M2 receptors are located on both. So with respect to heart, if you will see, it will decrease the heart rate and force of contraction, and with respect to blood vessel, if you will see, it will dilate the blood vessel since it is inhibitory in nature. Then next organ, if you will see, the GI system, okay, with respect to GI system, gastrointestinal, since the M3 receptors are present, 3 is odd number, so these are stimulatory in nature, so it is going to stimulate the muscles, like it increases the peristalsis as well as it increases the secretions because of the M3 receptors. And bladder pe, if you will see, it will contract the bladder since M3 receptors are located. And salivary glands, all salivary glands, including like the trick which we have seen in our earlier video, it is slumbag, okay. तो इट इज़ गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द सलाइवरी सिक्रीशंस, लैक्रिमल सिक्रीशंस, ओके, यूरिनरी मीन्स यूरिन का आउटपुट, एवरीथिंग, ऑल सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स, सॉरी दिस इज सलाइवरी ग्लैंड, ऑल एक्सक्रीटरी ग्लैंड्स, मतलब सॉरी सिक्रीटरी ग्लैंड्स, जो भी सिक्रीशंस है, मतलब आई से लैक्रिमल सिक्रीशन, ओके, फिर सलाइवा, देन योर यूरिन आउटपुट, all secretions will be increased, like here also it is bronchoconstriction, so secretion increase karne ka kaam, that is stimulatory effect it is having. So as you can see here, only heart and blood vessel pe it is having inhibitory effect because of the presence of M2 receptors. So these are the effects which are produced by the acetylcholine. So this I have represented in written form. Heart पे M2 है, so it decreases heart rate, okay, then blood vessel पे it is causing vasodilation, again since means like see blood vessel पे again M2 receptor, so it is dilating, okay, then smooth muscles again since M3 contraction produce हो रहा है, okay, bronchospasms है, bronchoconstriction, देन आइज पे मायोटिक इफेक्ट है M3 रिसेप्टर्स, देन ग्लैंड्स पे अगेन M3 रिसेप्टर्स, सो ऑल सिक्रीशंस विल बी इंक्रीज लाइक स्वेट सिक्रीशंस, सलाइवा, लैक्रिमल सिक्रीशंस, ओके, गैस्ट्रिक सिक्रीशंस, ब्रोंक्यूलर सिक्रीशंस, एवरीथिंग. देन व्हेन यू कम टू दिस NM एंड NN, दैट इज निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर्स, सो NM as we discussed the skeletal muscles, okay, neuromuscular junction of skeletal muscle which is responsible for contraction of muscles, and autonomic ganglia, like as you can see here in the image, autonomic ganglia ka ganglia jo hum logo ne dekha tha, okay, here the nicotinic receptors NN are present, okay, so NM and NN nicotinic receptors, and neuromuscular junction if you will see here, this is the neuron, okay, this is the effector organ, this junction, this NM receptors are present, so what they are doing on the NM receptor, that is neuromuscular junction ka receptors, neuromuscular junction pe effector organ pe jo receptor hai jahan pe acetylcholine jata hai, then sodium ka influx ke wajah se, okay, कैल्शियम रिलीज एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच कॉन्ट्रैक्शन टेक प्लेस. सो दिस इज अ स्मॉल पिक्चोरिटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन दैट हाउ इट कॉजेज द मसल का कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, ओके, एंड द फर्दर डिटेल्स ऑफ सिंपथेटिक एंड पैरासिंपथेटिक सिस्टम वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इन आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियोज. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ न्यूरोमस्क्युलर जंक्शन इन द इमेज विच आई हैव शोन इट टू यू. That is responsible for contraction of muscle through this mechanism. Sodium influx and then calcium release take place and muscle contraction occurs. So acetylcholine, as you can see here, the IU pack and the structure we have already seen. Then the enzyme which is responsible for metabolizing it is acetylcholine esterase. That means acetylcholine ka degradation jo karta hai, वो एंजाइम है एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज, एंड एसिटाइलकोलीन को सिंथेसाइज जो करता है वो एंजाइम है कोलीन एसिटाइल ट्रांसफरेज, विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन आवर अर्लियर वीडियो अबाउट द एसिटाइलकोलीन का सिंथेसिस, स्टोरेज एंड इट्स उसका डिग्रेडेशन. ओके, विद दिस वी फिनिश विथ एसिटाइलकोलीन का ऑल थिंग्स विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द exam point of view. Official preparation brand names they are not asking only in the exam. Thank you.